Islanders had their three-game winning streak snapped on Sunday in Carolina, but this team has been remarkable in bounce-back games. They have not lost back-to-back games in regulation this season and are off as the only team left without a regulation loss on home ice. The Islanders 6-0-2 here at Barclays Center. Right away by Travis Sanheim. Left back for Claude Giroux. To the center, Couturier. Hit Voracek. Jake Voracek back for Sean Couturier. Wanted to go back across. It's loose in front, and Kreiss got there. Couple of big saves right off the bat for Thomas Kreiss tonight.
Can you see the puck in its entirety cross the goal line as Thomas Kreiss has his pad there?
That's a save in my book.
Yep, I Brendan, and he needed all of those muscles in his legs to get across.
Well,
here we go.
It's always fun when Wes McCauley gets to announce these, so we'll listen in. Oh, he's got to get his microphone working, though. Come on, Wes, it's your big moment.
Well, he didn't give it the testing.
Oh, and we're just robbed of a
mic's not working.
There we go.
Oh, there it is. After reviewing the play, the call on the ice stands, no goal.
Well done, Wes.
That's perseverance. But that's a huge save to start this hockey game. Allow the Islanders to get on track.
Now Boychuk winds, put it down with a shot that hit off a skate. Scooped up here by Lee. Back for Boychuk. Fires one. Elliott left the rebound, reaching for Tavares. The puck rolls free. Spilling to the ice was Lee. Puck still bouncing around inside the Flyer zone. Started ahead by Travis Sanheim. And then Konechny in front, Raffle! And Kreiss is there to shut the door. Mayfield trying to stay with Scott Laughton. Laughton taken down to the ice and spinning with it here is Sanheim with a shot. Bounced in! Off of Taylor Lear in front. And the first goal tonight goes to Philadelphia.
Lear driving to the net after he got the puck back to the point. Quick shot from the point angle. And doesn't look like there was any interference. It was kind of after the fact. Good second effort to get that puck back to the point. Go to the middle of the ice, let the shot go, and you can see Lear just driving towards that. Might have gone off his right foot, Brendan. Take a little look. As you can see, it goes right off the foot, and it's probably going to be a good goal.
Yeah, definitely off the leg or the foot, but no distinct kicking motion, and you saw the contact that appeared to be after the puck had already gone behind Thomas Kreiss. So Beauvillier and Provorov, both rookies last season. As Seidenberg's shot just changed directions and didn't miss by much. Then Mayfield gave it away. Here's Denis Martel in on a breakaway in his NHL debut, and it's fought off by Kreiss. Martel on his own rebound, and then Beauvillier gets in the way. Tavares in the high slot, Barzal all the way across. Letty gives it to Barzal, steps down goal line. Lee in front wanted Tavares. He found Lear's stick instead. Islanders still control in the offensive end. Letty for Bailey. Bailey for Lee. Lee in front, and he couldn't connect with Tavares there. Barzal on the retrieval. Quick spin back towards the goal. Sets it up for Letty at the top. 40 seconds into the power play. Tavares, good movement for Barzal. Letty, one-timer, pinballed off of Elliott. Then back around, Barzal. Step, shoot, scores! A power play goal for Matt Barzal. Islanders tie it at one.
Well, it all starts with a face-off win that gives you automatic control. And boy, oh boy, did the Islanders look sharp on that power play. Obviously, they had time to practice it over the last couple of days, and it showed with the quick puck movement. They were looking for John Tavares a whole lot in the slot area. Finally, Nick Letty gets a shot. I'm not sure Elliott saw that, but again, Bailey over to Barzal, and then the shot. So Matthew Barzal getting more involved offensively with the shooting aspect of the game. He loves to pass the puck, but that's a wonderful shot in off the post. But I love the movement of the puck. It was so quick. It was set up. It was executed as well as you could possibly imagine.
Latt and Barzal and Everly both nearby. Pass game ahead, and look out here. A breakaway opportunity for Raffle again. The backhand off the post and then in. Michael Raffle on a breakaway, and the Flyers take a 2-1 lead here in the opening minute of the frame.
The Islanders had two lefties on the ice, both DeHaan and Letty, so I'm not sure if there was a bad change as Raffle right off the bat has a clear-cut break. We can see the coach is a little upset. Quick pass up. Nobody close to Raffle. Second breakaway. This time he hangs on a little longer. Thomas Grice makes the original save or takes away the angle, and then it goes in off his skate. But I don't know where the Islanders are in their defense.
Marcel got the faceoff to Baylor. Good start for the Islanders here on this two-man advantage. Tavares out high. Closes in. Barzal back to Tavares. Then Boychuk. Wine slaps it down for Bailey. Bailey. Boychuk got loose in front and he scores! Johnny Boychuk with a perfectly placed shot. It's tied at two and the power play will continue.
Well, again, a good faceoff win, even though it was a secondary centerman. Tavares didn't got thrown out. Barzal won it. But this is a well-designed, conceived play as both Boychuk and Tavares move around. Just watch the switch here. Boychuk's going to come back into the slot area and then a quick shot as he lets it go. Good fake by Bailey and then a high up in the toy department for Johnny Boychuk. I don't know what he was aiming there, but he sure got it there. Loads the gun and says, yep, thanks, baby. All smiles and the Islanders have tied it up.
Near boards, it's Pellick. Rips it across. Received by Hosang. Hosang cruising in, leaves it to the back. Pellick, a slap pass over for Eberle. Eberle for Pellick. Now slid to Hosang. Hosang in front. Nelson, Eberle, and a stack pad saved by Elliott. Back in front of an open net. Hosang loads it up and can't pull the trigger. Pellick will shoot. A save from Elliott, and he dives on that loose puck.
But that they practiced that. They diagrammed that.
There's a shot tip. Score! Hosang knocked it out of the air just before it got to Elliott. And for the moment, the Islanders have a 3-2 lead.
As the referees converge together to see, they'll probably review this, although they seem to be happy. We'll see if the Philadelphia Flyers, Dave Haxtell, whether they checked that out or not. But it starts with a faceoff win. Talked about a line that needed to get a goal and create some offense. We'll just see if they want to challenge that. Shot by Pellick towards the net. Hard to tell from that angle, but you're always going to question whether or not that's a high stick.
Again, this all has to come from Toronto.
That's
only goaltender interference, and Mike is yours.
After reviewing the play, the call on the ice is confirmed. We have a goal.
But also the offense being freed up a little bit by taking some of those slashes out of the game. Gostisbehere for Voracek as the power play begins. Played for Gostisbehere and then Giroux back to Gostisbehere at the top. 10 power play assists this season for Shane Gostisbehere as they work it to Simmons across for Voracek. Off the post and in! Jake Voracek with a power play goal and we're tied once more.
Well conceived, and the Flyers have always had a good power play. It's always been one of the reasons why they've been able to stay in the pack, give themselves an opportunity to get to the playoffs. Their 5-on-5 play is not all that great, but what a pass by Simmons. You can see the Flyers, they move it down below, and it's going to be the key pass to Simmons, and he doesn't look. He knows exactly where Voracek is. Voracek's on the dot. He's waiting there, waiting for the pass. Simmons took a little look. You can see there, he knows where Voracek is, and the perfect shot. The Hawk can't get into the shooting lane, so a real nice power play by the Philadelphia Flyers.
Boychuk and Filppula battle again. Kicked away by Boychuk. Lifted in the air, but gloved down by Travis Konechny. Boychuk and Filppula transition their battle to the front of the goal. And then Boychuk ahead for Tavares. 2-on-1 with Bailey. John Tavares left side. Tavares, Bailey, Elliott got there to make the save. Mayfield strong on the puck. Back on it, it's Hosang. Hosang, nice feed. Beauvillier, Nelson, shoot, save, rebound! And it couldn't be knocked home by Beauvillier.
Maturing, that's all he is. He's just a young lad that's learning the National Hockey game, league game, and getting better and better, but he does so many things well.
Boychuk took a look, found Tavares, found Bailey, found Lee. Backhand was stopped by Elliott. Would have been pretty, wouldn't go. Turnover, Tavares back in with speed to the outside. Tavares, stutter step. Haig tries to stay with him. Lee, back of the goal with Tavares, who gets away. Pellick starts to creep in. Tavares, trying to force one through for Letty. Bounce to Lee, quick turnaround shot, right back in front. And swept away from the goal mouth. Giroux hit the referee. Bailey to Lee, and Lee can't muscle it to the front. Now Bailey has a shot, and where is it?
Anders Lee so strong, the quick pass out to Bailey, and it's just a little bit of a shot.
The last 5 years, only Alexander Ovechkin has more power play goals than the 46 scored by Wayne Simmonds. He's parked in front, and he set up the first power play goal for the Flyers. As Goss Despair took a shot that Simmonds got a piece of. A
couple different deflections it looked like there.
Clutterbuck knocks his man down, the puck high in the air, glove down by Simmonds. Simmonds went to center, came to Couturier across the ice, and a save from Greiss on Voracek. Bailey enters the offensive zone as the Islanders try and get set up. Left off for John Tavares. Tavares tried to stick handle away around Couturier, couldn't do it. Lost an edge and he got pushed from behind, got back to his feet, still with control of the puck as they try to hold on to him. Tavares pulls it with one hand back, sets up Bailey, save, score! Bailey the winner, what a play from Tavares to set it up for the Islanders' win! Oh, baby!
Well, you have to watch John Tavares often enough to see that kind of magic, because sooner or later, it's going to surface. It doesn't happen every game, it doesn't happen every shift, but there's so very few players in the world that can do what he just did. I mean, Couturier played him as well as anybody could imagine. He was physical, he maintained position. He got John Tavares down on his knees, he got back up, he continued to push him.
On Friday, but Bailey starts it, and then watch John Tavares go to work.
This is just crazy. Look at, knocked down, gets back up, protects the puck, just fighting off Couturier. Look at the work Couturier's doing. He finally pins him, but Tavares stays with it, spots Bailey all the while. Just a scary situation.